There is nothing wrong with marriage as such. There is never wrong with anything wrong with anything. Marriage appears like the most important problem only because you happen to spend the maximum time with your family, with your wife, with your kids, and because you have invested largely in them. Move away from your family for a few months and you will find that you have several other problems as well. There are only problems. It's just that some problems get your focus and the others do not. Shift your focus from one problem and you will discover that there are problems and problems and problems galore. The entire room is stinking. The entire room is turning into some kind of a cesspool. We always keep talking of particular actions. No particular action is ever wrong. It is the actor who is either right or wrong. Marriage can be a beautiful thing. Let the Buddha decide to marry. Remarry, that is. Let Krishna marry and marry again and again. It would be a beautiful marriage because Krishna is beautiful. Let the wise one marry. It would be a beautiful marriage because wisdom is beautiful. If Krishna marries, nothing can go wrong in that marriage. And even if an idiot doesn't marry, all is going to go wrong with him. So marriage cannot be blamed. Don't blame marriage. Marriage is neither good nor bad. It is what you make of it. Your marriage will exactly be the same as you are. Every relationship that you have will be just as you are. The world is in fact just as you are. If you get wedded to the other because you feel lonely, what is going to be the result of such a marriage? You are only going to possess and dominate the other. You are going to latch onto the other. You will be a parasite. You are dependent on the other. The point where you begin the marriage is exactly the point the marriage will keep returning to again and again and again. If you got into the marriage because you were under social pressure, because you were afraid, then your marriage will keep returning to fear again and again. If you got into the marriage because you were lonely, then in spite of your marriage, loneliness will haunt you again and again. If you got into the marriage because you were sexually desirous, then in spite of the marriage, your desire would never be quenched. The beginning of anything is also the result of that thing. See who you are. Don't blame specific things, specific events, others or the world. Don't unnecessarily hassle your spouse. He or she is probably as clueless as you are. He needs your support. She needs your light. Take care of yourself and then you will be able to take care of everybody.